All right, so we're back here at site B. We've got something new we're gonna be trying out here. One of the problems was the velocity of the rocks dropping onto our grizzly bars. Yeah, just a lot of quick volume. So we're getting a lot of excess dirt from the grizzly bars into the truck bed. I wanna try and just slow that velocity down. So this is repurposed. This was my original test for my snow pusher, so we're just going to try this out before I go with the final design. That's why we had wood on the previous over at site A renditions of this, so that the dump truck could run up the ramp and dump into this bed. And I had to do something similar, being able to slow that velocity of that rock down so that we could get good dirt rock separation, because I want the dirt to all fall in here, as much of it as possible, and the rocks to fall into the truck. So we're gonna try this out, just see how it works. And we're gonna continue working on some design modifications to get this set up so I can make something out of metal for it. So we'll try this out and see how it works today. So we gotta go get the bucket for the excavator there, and then we can get started. Right, so we're different day today. We're gonna do the same thing, but differently. Too many problems. Number one, I lost my dog bone. So I'm running two-wheel drive, open diff. So we'll see how well it does. We'll try and keep it on hard surfaces. For now, I ordered a new CVD joint drive axle for the, or drive shaft for this thing. So that should be here a couple weeks. I'll go ahead and leave this dog bone for now. It's fine. But this thing's fallen out like five times on me. I've got more articulation and a little bit more movement. And so it's been falling out since I did the upgrade on the lift and the suspension. So more parts, but we'll get that fixed. So we'll limit the use of this guy as much as we can. Try and not get him stuck too much, but you might see me giving him a push here and there. And the excavator, let's get out here to this guy, was the second problem. And another reason why I just shut it down yesterday. Just wasn't turning out to be a good day. You guys know how that goes. But the slew motor just started spinning on me with any kind of resistance against the bucket. I was trying to hook up my bucket and then it would just spin. It wouldn't allow me to move the bucket around. It would still rotate as long as I didn't have any pressure or resistance. So the set screw on the pinion had just backed up just enough where it was just allowing that motor to spin. There was still resistance, but it was still spinning. So what I did on the drive shaft is I shaved off the flat spot a little bit more, so it's a bigger flat spot area for that set screw to go into. I've already used the pink Loctite. I've used the blue Loctite. So now I've got the Tamiya blue Loctite, which really kind of hardens up pretty good. So we'll see how that works, as well as I went ahead and put some of my foam tack on the shaft when I put the pinion back on it, so that hopefully that'll help it to not get quite so much movement and loosen that set screw up. So that's just been a constant battle with this thing. But take a look at this. I mean, check that out. There's like no slop. That's why I was kind of surprised when it slopped on a couple videos back when I did this upgrade and was telling you about my pet peeves with this thing. Is I noticed there was quite a bit of slop, and I'm like, man, I thought I took care of that. But I should have dug into it then, but I didn't. So I dug into it yesterday, got that fixed. So now, I mean, look at there, there's hardly any slop. And I'd upped the tooth. I went from like a 12 to 13 tooth pinion on that, which closed the gapping really nice in there. So that eliminated most of that slop. I mean, that is fantastic. If it'll stay like that, I'll be happy. So let's get to work. Overshoot. jam up in here. I think I might need a shaker or something on this. All right, so let's try this with a little change of pitch and height. Looks like I'll still be able to drop it in there. Dropping better into the truck. Need something right here angled out so that it'll catch and move it towards the center so I don't have to drop so much over the grizzly bars either. That would extend my usable reach. Because if I could even drop like right here and have it still run towards the center of the grizzlies. And this height won't be so much right here. I'm just trying to see how much gap I need right here. And kind of some of the angles that I'm going to need. Yeah, if that was all just scooped out, a lot like I did for this. It'll channel it, that would work out pretty good, I think. We got a biggie. Look at that. I think we'll just move him out of the way. We'll put him over here for the... Come grab him with the forks on the loader. I think we got another one right there. Not as big, but bigger than I can put through my screener. Grizzly bars, drop him over there. All right. So I better watch my load in my dump truck there. We'll drop this one. Maybe a small one here. Looks like it's scooching down pretty good. We just got that little hang up over here.
But I've got that much flat lip, so it's not allowing the rock to drop.
Let's get this guy parked set here. think I got a rock in there that's too big to go through. Okay, keep eye on that. Mercedes dump truck too, make sure I don't overfill before pulling it forward. Cheesy. Got a little carried away there. He'll go through. Let's give him another nudge. There we go. Let's go check the load. Because what I was wanting is to make sure that the dirt is less. Oh, look, we're already full on the back end. So, get a little bit of the fine grain there. It's not bad. Once I start getting overfill, it starts getting over here quite a bit. First, we got these little rocks that always kind of hang up in here. Those kind of cause the ones that get stuck in between the that are just the right size. Nothing I can do about that. It's just gonna happen, I think. But it looks like I'm getting kind of what I want. Almost all the dirt. Yeah, I mean, of course, what sticks to the rocks is going to stick to the rocks, but that's It's a lot better than what it was doing. I'm just getting a lot of silt from the bottom of my rock wash. Take as much of the dirt out as possible, get it loaded in that truck. So that's only, what, two loads full in this guy, which I'll call that a full load, because any more than that, it just starts stacking up and causing me problems. But that's half a dump truck load, almost there, from loading that up twice. So let's go dump this and do some more. I'm liking the way this test is turning out so far. Oh. Well, that ain't gonna help my cause. Getting close, we're starting to build up on that side. I was thinking the flap too.
This right here, extending it out more towards midway.
I did it more towards midway on the dump bed to help distribute that load out towards the middle a little bit. As long as the velocity's slow enough where it won't overshoot my bed. Dropping. It's looking pretty good. Looks like we're dropping just right there. drop one more, maybe two more buckets in there.
Looks like that'll be about all my
Mercedes will be able to take before moving it up a little bit. One more. I need to reposition my excavator too. Even though I got these hydraulics turned way down pressure-wise, it's still enough to pull this machine around. Better watch my, need to pull myself over a little bit now. Still not going to clear. There we go. Now I'll clear it. Yep, I already got too much in the dump truck. Better stop there. All right, let's get this thing out of here. Thank you.
Like my slope there got a little out of whack. Definitely need to keep that slope tighter so I don't get so much material hanging up on there. Looks like we need to move the dump truck up a little bit. Yeah, we'll do a little bit more. I gotta check my other dump truck. Scooch material in there here in a second. 10.5 volts, that's where I call it quits. Out of fuel. Alright, let's take this two-wheel drive open diff truck and dump it and see what she can do.
Oh, I'm already stuck. She don't want to back up.
Oh no. Oh, she's stuck.
Yeah, especially since it's the thinner axle. Man, I get the dump bed where I really like it, and it's something else now. Oh, I can't wait to get that drive shaft in. I mean, look at that thing go sit down so fast now. Oh, I'm stuck. Let's see if we can get some momentum. I know it's a little rough, does not look good, but it's getting me an idea of how it will work or could work. You know, if I get this thing built out very similar to this, where I've got a nice V shape to it, then I think it'll work pretty decent. Because what I'd like to do too is build a ramp up to it for my loader, so I can just dump my loader in this way also on it, and I can work this either way, and then also another ramp coming up from the other way so my dump truck can dump into it as well.
Thank you. Thank you.